Hi, I'm Ben from Siemens Digital Industries Software. The June 2025 release of NX CAD has some incredible new features and enhancements to its design and modeling capabilities. Let's take a look at how they work and how they can help you design better and faster. We'll start with Sketch. It's a core part of designing in NX, with almost all products involving sketches somewhere in the design process. It's also an area that sees consistent innovation and regular updates through our continuous release model. June 2025 is no different, with three major new Sketch features to show you. The first is Sketch Navigator. It's a new tool that allows you to easily browse and analyze individual elements, relations, and dimensions that comprise a sketch. It uses the same detailed hierarchical format that you're familiar with from the Part Navigator and Assembly Navigator. So, getting started is simple and intuitive. Hover over or select an item in the Navigator to see it highlighted in the graphics window and vice versa. The information is organized into four convenient tabs at the top of the Sketch Navigator window: curves, relations, external references, and issues. In the curves tab, the status column shows us which curves are dimensioned with a black circle. At the top, the status of the overall sketch indicates whether or not the sketch is fully defined. It's a quick and easy way to see your progress while you sketch and do a final check when you're done. The Relations tab collects all the sketch's dimensions, expressions, persistent relations, and found relations. You can edit the value of a dimension directly within the Sketch Navigator and double-click on a persistent relation to instantly open and edit the relevant command. Select a line or curve in the graphics window to view and edit the found relations for that element. Right-click the sketch itself in the Sketch Navigator to access another efficient way to manipulate the sketch: edit parameters. This gives you a live preview of the changes to dimensions or relations as you edit the values either numerically or with the slider tool. The External References tab lists all internal features of the sketch with external references. It's useful to have these listed separately since, unlike everything else, you can't edit them within the sketch itself. The final tab in Sketch Navigator, Issues, brings us to the next new feature we want to show you: Sketch Checking. Sketch Checking is a validation tool that can automatically check your work for near conditions and correct them for you. It can speed up your sketching workflows dramatically because you don't need to worry about getting everything exactly right the first time. Run Sketch Checking when you're finished, and you can have the confidence that NX will produce a sketch with the right level of geometric precision. It works by identifying near misses between sketch features and common geometric relationships. For example, if the sketch has two lines which are almost parallel but not quite, that's the sort of thing that Sketch Checker would flag as an issue. There's a wide range of different checks that NX can analyze your sketch against. You can turn each one off and on as required and adjust the margin of error. You can also choose whether NX displays sketch checking results automatically as you sketch or only once you finish. Those results are where the Issues tab from earlier comes in. You can view sketch checking results on the sketch itself in the graphics window or listed in the Sketch Navigator's Issues tab. In either location, you have the option to automatically correct an issue or ignore it if it's a false positive. You can also deactivate a particular check if it's not relevant for your sketch overall. Next up, we have a brand new user interface for creating curves in Sketch. Integrated with a range of core sketch commands, it's a flexible and easy to use approach for sketching curves, heavily informed by feedback from our user community. And it's compatible with mouse, stylus, and touchscreen to match a variety of modern design workflows. Begin drawing a curve, and the pencil icon will indicate that you're in curve creation mode. There are three modes of contextual behavior, indicated by the color of the handle next to the pencil. Blue indicates that no snapping is occurring. Yellow means that point-on curve snapping is recognized, and green indicates coincident snapping. NX intelligently switches to the most relevant mode as you move the cursor around the sketch, making curve creation more efficient than ever before. Next up, we'll show you some enhancements to the advanced shape design capabilities in realized shape. Realize Shape gives you easy-to-use tools for creating advanced freeform shapes through powerful and intuitive subdivision modeling technology. It's ideal for creating designs with fluid organic geometry and is popular for products where ergonomics and aerodynamics are factors. It's included as standard in the NXX Design Premium tier and available through value-based licensing for users of other tiers. The standard chamfer command will be familiar to most designers using NX. The new Chamfer Cage command brings chamfer functionality into the Realize Shape task environment. In Realize Shape, the subdivision surface geometry is generated within a cage. You control the geometry by manipulating the cage rather than interacting with it directly. Chamfer Cage works the same way and applies a chamfer to the subdivision cage that controls the body. This gives you fine control of the feature by adjusting the relation between it and the cage. You can apply the command to both sharp and smooth cage edges. The continuity setting has sharp and smooth settings as well, which result in chamfer edges and blend edges respectively on the subdivision body. Offset and weight values for the chamfer provide additional fine control, and you can preview the changes in the graphics window before you commit. Together with the existing Transform Cage command, Chamfer Cage gives you greater flexibility when refining and sculpting the subdivision body. It's particularly useful in transition areas on a part and edges between flat and curved faces. The Blend Curve on Surface command builds upon previous enhancements to the Curve on Surface command, so you can add extra detail to curve-based modeling workflows more efficiently. Previously, creating a blend in the middle of a surface would require you to first sketch a curve on a separate plane. With Blend Curve on Surface, you can now apply fillets or chamfers directly to curves on the surface itself. It's a quicker and more intuitive way to fine-tune your geometry. And it doesn't end there. NX Immersive Designer now extends NX design and modeling capabilities into the immersive space as well. Along with the Sony head-mounted display and controllers tailored specifically for 3D design, you can experience the next generation of product engineering. Click the link in the description to learn more about NX Immersive Designer, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the next What's New in NX video. Thanks for watching.